Ladies and gentlemen, this is the big album time for the superstar, Cardi B.
Yo.
How you doing though? How you okay, let me ask you this. It happened so fast.
Yes.
How are you dealing with the rate at which you became this phenomenon?
You wanna know something? No, it didn't happen so fast.
Okay.
Because, you know, a lot of people see that it happened so fast because they just saw the impact that Bodak Yellow did. But like for 2 years straight, I was really on some like, it's like, I gotta go to this radio station. Mm. I gotta talk to this person. Every state that I used to go to, that I used to host, I always used to go to a radio station, used to talk to local DJs. I used to be on calls with DJs. I did my own tour for my first mixtape.
Gangsta Volume 1.
Yeah, I invested money in that shit. And I invested a lot of money on music. So to me, it didn't feel like it was so fast. Like sometimes I used to cry. Like I used to be like, this is just, it's never gonna happen. And I'm a person that is very realistic. I'm not the type of person to be like, I'm gonna follow my dreams until I can no more. I'm the type of person that put a deadline and a time period because it's like, money is getting wasted.
So you was gonna quit? Getting invested.
Yeah, hell yeah, because I just felt like it's just like, it's not happening. And, you know, Bodak Yellow happened, and it just, boom, all of a sudden, it just started hitting. But the fame I got from it, the responses, the expectations, it did hit me fast, like, too fast. It was like,
because it was bigger than big. It was, yeah. I mean, A-list right away.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And it was like, oh, nobody gave me a warning that these type of, they happen like this. Wait a minute now, like, come on, give me a second.
You was getting your shmoney though. You been out here getting that money.
Hell yeah, I want all the money, because you want to know something? With the way the internet, the way that everything is set up, you might say one thing that people don't agree with.
Mm.
You might do something that is so, that people don't agree with, that people won't understand, and boom, all of a sudden, like, your popularity is gone, or, like, everybody is against you. So, I always be like, I'm gonna get this bag, because I don't know if this bag gonna be here tomorrow. That's why I just be chasing it.
Going. So, on the album, you have a record, I Like It Like That, you shot the video, you know, channeling Celia Cruz, you know what I'm saying? Which you giving us some of that Spanish Caribbean vibe right here, you know what I'm saying? And Afro Latino vibe. Talk. Why was it important for you to give that Celia Cruz moment in the video?
I didn't really thought it was a Celia Cruz moment. I just think it was very like Spanish. But then it's like, it was a different type of Spanish to me, too, because it was like very Cuban-ish, and it's like very tropical, and that's not the type of Spanish or Hispanic, I guess. I don't know. People always have
different names
to it. You know, everybody now is classifying now. I don't know. You know, the internet want to classify everything, and it's like it's so crazy to me to see the culture, different type of Hispanic cultures in different places. Like, it's like, over here is very Celia Cruz. And I grew up in a different type of Hispanic culture, like the Heights.
Yeah.
That is more like,
it's more hood, it's more street.
It's more trappy.
Yeah.
It's more Dominican.
Right. Do you, now, you got, how important was it for you to link up with Bad Bunny and J Balvin on that record?
It was very important for me. Well, it's very important first with Ozuna, because it's just like those Ozuna, his music used to make me cry. Like, it's like, I hate. And then it's like, oh my God, I love him so much. And then it's like, for him to want to collaborate with me, that means so much. And then Bad Bunny and J Balvin, it's so crazy. Like, these guys are at the top, right?
Mm-hmm.
These guys are at the top of their game, and they getting paid the same or probably even more that I get paid of. And when I meet these, like, they man humble, like, and they thanking me, and it's like, no, thank you.
Yeah.
And it's so important for me, because it's just like, you think that these guys, that they so up at what they do, they will be like, nah, I don't have the time, I don't have the this. So it was just like so important and so dear for me, that it's like, if you ever need a kidney, I'll give it to you.
I got you. You are making a lot of waves with this most recent record, Be Careful, which when I heard it, I was excited that you did a different sound, right? Mm-hmm. I think with Bodak Yellow and Bardier Cardi, obviously that's more of a street, strip club sound. But Be Careful is like one of those like records that you hear back, like it reminds you of high school, like a high school breakup song, you know what I mean? That one of those anthems. Was it on purpose that you took a sonic, a different turn to kind of give people a, because I saw you tweet, like sometimes you gotta change it up a little bit for people.
It wasn't really on purpose. You know, like my boy Partisan, mm-hmm. I heard that record, we was chilling, and I heard that record, and I was like, yo, I love this record. It was like a verse, just one verse. And I was like, this is crazy. Like, I just wanna, and then it's like, I told him like, yo, I really want this record. Like, we need to work on this record. Like, I want it for me. And he said, alright, why not? Like, all right, go ahead, take it. Like, we just make sure that you kill it. Matter of fact, I wanna be with you when you do the record. And it's just like, I wanted that record. And it's just like, it's not that it's the most important from all my songs. It's just like, when I do this song, when I hear this song, like, I be really crying. Like, it just really means so much. It gets me angry. It gets me sad. And I know that I felt like women are going to relate. I know, like, bitches that don't even like me is going to relate. I know that somebody's mom is going to relate. Like,
I'm assuming you're talking about Offset.
No, I wasn't talking about Offset. I just was talking about things that I relate to and that have happened to me. Maybe it's certain things that, like, you know, it just you just think about different type of things that you went with different type of man. Anyways, I heard the record before I even, like, was in love with Offset like that and everything. Because it's like, you know, our relationship is like, you know, first we liked each other, but we was very protective of each other because people would put things in your ears. Mm-hmm. And it's like, I got to protect my heart. But then it's like I gave in. Just love each other.
And now y'all all the way in.
Yeah.
So other than working with Partisan Fontaine on this record, there was other people that had to hear this record. How major, I mean, talk about Lauryn Hill and her listening to this song and helping, you know, I mean, obviously she had to clear it, right?
Yes, and it's like that was one of the most, it was like the most like thing that we was really nervous about because it's like one of my favorite parts is like care for me, care for, and it's like if she didn't approve it, then it's a no go for it, and she approved it, and it's like not only because it's like she had to hear the record to approve it or not, and it's like not only was a relief, but it was just like, yo, I cannot believe Lauryn Hill approved this record. Like I cannot, because I don't care about anybody. This is Lauryn Hill. And it's like for her to approve it, it's just like the biggest stamp to it. Like it's like nobody could talk about this record to me because like the sensei approved it.
Yeah.
So it's just like you just cannot say anything to me. Like the sensei approved it. And it was such a relief. And it's such a, everybody was like, that's unbelievable.
So the collaborations on the album, I expected the Migos on the album, right? Love the record. I think it's called Drip.
Yeah.
Great record. YG made sense. I was like, okay, YG, right? That made sense. Dope collab. Love that record. Did not expect Chance the Rapper.
Yes.
Talk to me about how that came together.
Because I just felt like he was just so perfect for this song, I'm living my best life.
Yeah, positive. Energy.
It's really positive, yeah. Really energy. Something really different for me. And it's just like, he is the one. He is the one. I want you, please.
So you reached out to him?
Yep.
Yeah. And he was, what was that like? He was easy to work with?
He was very easy to work with. Like, I am so grateful for everybody that, decided to be on my album because as an artist, I know how busy, I know how busy artists are. And for them to even take the time and for them to take the time and do it exactly right, it's just like, thank you so much. And everything came out how I wanted to come out, like perfect hooks, perfect verses. Like, it's just like, oh my God, Jesus loved me. I must did something right in my life.
SZA's on the album. Another collaboration I didn't anticipate.
Yeah.
How did you guys work that? You reached out to her, you guys, because I know she's a song, she writes hooks and songs too. She's written for Rihanna and other people. Was that how you guys came together?
No, I just really had this dope idea, and I reached out to her, and she's very busy, but it's just like, we gonna keep reaching out. But she always said, like, I'm going to do it. I'm going to do it. And she did it. And it's like, oh, thank God. It's so hard for me to be in the studio with people because it's just like, I be flying from here to there. And they just be so busy themselves. It's just like, all right, listen, I'm going to send you this. I'm going to send you the verse. I'm going to send you how this. What you think about this? You don't like this? Okay, that is okay. I'm going to change it. I'll change it for you. Whatever you want to do, I'll change it for you. Here. All right, like it now? Okay, do it.
What did you work on as a rapper? Because I noticed one of our last conversations we had at Apple Music, you told me straight up, you was like, look, I'm trying to get better. You was like, look, I'm really working hard to get better at this rap thing and get better at rapping. And we've kind of watched you grow musically in front of our eyes.
At flowing.
Yeah.
Just flowing better, learning better. It's just like, that's one thing that I feel like I got in myself better. And then it's just like, I also needed a little bit of help. Mm-hmm. So I got my friend Morrison.
Yeah.
Like, I needed a little bit of help from breaking out of my box. Like, I feel like my music was, if you listen to my mixtape, it's very trappy and it's really like almost like drill. Cause it's just like, It's just like, I just be feeling like sometimes I felt like I will never get out of that style. Like, I'm so stuck of rapping like that. In any beat, and it's just like, I need to break that shell. I need to break that shell, and I need to learn how to flow a little bit easier and cleaner. And I feel like I don't feel like I perfected it yet, but I feel like I'm getting better and better and better and better and better. And it's like, I feel like if I take my time too, I will even be better. Like, it's like, I be in the studio, but it's just like, sometimes that bag be calling, and I want that bag. Like, it's like, oh, I could do this tomorrow, but today I'm going to get this bag. Today I'm going to Mississippi, and I'm going to do that concert.
Yeah.
Oh, today I'm doing that. And then, like, you know, magazines be calling. Like, you know, one of my passions is fashion, and it's like, a magazine called me, and it's just like, I cannot help to take the opportunity. Mm-hmm. So, just a lot of things. And then personal life. Like, people just don't think you have a personal life. Sometimes you just gotta take a day off just to go to the damn doctor. Mm-hmm. Or sometimes you gotta take a damn day off just so you could, like, go with your mom to do certain appointments or with your, just with my dude, we be having to take days off because we just trying to build a house and everything. It's just a lot of things. Like, you living a lot of lives. A lot of lives is living in one body.
You putting out a clothing line since you love fashion so much, and the album cover is super fashionable. Have any of the big houses reached out to Cardi to do a line, collaborate?
Well,
I even did the hand. You saw the hand?
I saw it.
Saw the hand?
You know, I have a lot of new deals on the table.
Okay, so it could happen.
With Fashion Nova, they gave me an opportunity to design what I like and what I want to put out. And I'm going to put out a line with them, a little sign, something. I'm collaborating with them, like, for the fall and everything. And it's going to be great because it's just, like, it's what I like.
And they've been rocking with you since the beginning.
Yes, they've been rocking with me from the beginning. And then on top of that, it's just, like, it's Fashion Nova is big. And I know that a lot of people cannot afford expensive. Nobody got no $500, $400. Now everybody got $500 for a damn shirt or sweatsuit. So everything is going to be affordable. And I want people to look good. I want people to look high-end with a good budget price. And that's the perfect opportunity. And I'm excited for that.
Have you, as the family, your sister, your mom, I know your sister, your mom, and I think your mom's sister, your aunt, y'all all kind of grew up in the same area in Washington Heights. Am I getting the people right?
No. No, my mom's side of the family, they live upstate New York.
Okay.
So my mom is the only one, like, from my mom's side that she live in the city. All my father family, they live in the Bronx or in the Heights.
Got it.
And my grandmother's house is in the Heights.
Do you guys plan on staying in Washington Heights? Or, I mean, obviously, with rent control in New York City, you want to keep that crib. Don't be giving up them houses, you know what I mean, them apartments.
You want to know something? My grandmother will never move from there. And first, they've been there for 30 years. Second of all, it's just like, people just don't understand. Like, my grandmother, my grandfather, they don't know how to drive. And people, when you're from New York, you need to understand that it's like, you could go outside downstairs and the store is in the corner.
Yeah.
And they don't want to move nowhere. Like, I live in Jersey, and I have a big space. I live in a big space, and they never want to go to my crib. It's boring for them. It's quiet. I have Caucasian neighbors that everything bothers them. And then on top of that, there is no stores around. Like, they can't drive to Target. Nobody knows how to drive. We don't drive.
You know how to drive?
No.
Never learned.
I never really cared to.
That's so New York. That's so New York. You gonna learn?
I have to learn because I'm buying all these damn cars and I don't know how to drive it. But I'm a professional passenger and I'm cool with that. I just don't ever have the time. But I really want to learn. But it's just like sometimes I just...
It takes a lot. It takes a lot. Offset told me, he said you made him come up I think it was to the Bronx or Washington Heights. He was like, yeah, I went up there, had some beans and rice with the family, was hanging out.
Yeah.
He said it was great. Like, the whole fam, he was just up there eating. You made him come up and experience it in the BX? Or was it Washington Heights?
It was Washington Heights, because it's my mom and my friends that live in the Bronx. My dad, too, he live in the Bronx. But everybody, like, the spot that everybody want to be at is grandma's house. Like, I want to be in grandma's house. Yeah. Oh, I feel so bad for my crib in Jersey because it's like nobody want to be in there. Not even.
But maybe you could convince them to come, like, maybe y'all do the holidays over there.
More no, you they can't. Won't do that? Because it's like after 12 o'clock, you got to turn down the music.
Maybe you just tell your neighbors we partying tonight.
They don't want to hear it. They be like, oh, that's really nice, but it's okay. I call the police. It's okay.
You got the cops cars on you already in Jersey?
One time. One time, but it was just...
Just turn the music down tight.
It wasn't really the music. You know, it was a couple of words, exchange, and stuff like that. Like, you know, 2 years ago. But it's just like, it's just not fun.
Cardi, on Invasion of Privacy, if we was to run through some of these records on here, we talked about the collabos, but you start the album with some real, like, you know... I want to say it's like a Dreams and Nightmares type intro. But it's your style on it, you know what I mean? And it's called Get Up. Talk to me about that record, because I think that's a record where you talk about stripping across the street from the school you went to.
I always want to, I'm not going to say defend strippers. I just don't feel like people don't understand it. I used to go to BMCC and there's a strip club that I worked across the street from it and everything. And I always want to let...
That's Borough Manhattan Community College.
Yeah. And then I just always want to let people know, like, I was a stripper. I wasn't a prostitute. I wasn't sucking for... I had to... First of all, that's illegal in New York City, okay?
You're going to jail.
You're going to jail. And you're going to jail, for real. And them clubs, they do not give a... They are not trying to lose their license.
Especially down there, the Wall Street joints, they're not playing. Them the old school joints.
I was really scared to put that song on the album because it's just like I felt like it was too much of my mixtape, my first mixtape, my second mixtape type of flow. But it's just like, fuck it, because it's like when I hear it, I can't help but to like shake my head like this. And it's just like, it means something so much for me. Like I even say in the song, like I was just trying to chill and make bangers. Like, people put this pressure on me and this expectation on me and be trying to, like, compare me to other women. And it's like, I never asked for that. I never asked for that. I came in this game trying to make money, make music, and go on my way. Like, a lot of people always want to tear me down because they want to put me up here. And it's just like, I never asked to be up here. And then I got a little cocky, too, because sometimes I got a little cocky on it. I got a little arrogant on it because it's just like, you know what? I be too humble and everything. I be too humble that I just got to remind people, like, you know what? My like, I have overly done proof. or to y'all. And y'all stay putting me down. I done been down so many times, and I get up every single damn time, every situation.
Let's talk about Drip with Migos. How is it? I mean, you obviously, you and Offset did Lick together. How is it working with the boyfriend? Is it easy? Is it annoying? Is it, what is it?
It's
all the above?
It's not annoying at all. Like, you know, it's just like, you know, guys be taking their girlfriends to the studio, or he has a studio in his house, and it's like you hear something, it's like, oh, I want to hop on it. Sometimes it is a little bit, it gets me shy, because it's like, oh my gosh, he's looking at me. Oh my gosh, I know I'm more New York, like we both have different type of sounds. I wonder if he gonna think that I'm whack or something like that. So it's just a little nerve-wracking, but then it's just like, and then it be on the spot, because he does his music on the spot. They all do their songs on their spot.
Quick.
And then when they be like, get in the booth, and it's like, nah, you gotta give me an hour to write something. Like, give me a second. They just all be there, and you just put it all there.
So you guys recorded Drip all together?
No. Me and Austin did Drip by ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
And that's when all of them came in. He just already had like that beat. He already got that drip. He had like a verse.
Mm-hmm.
I think he switched it up a little bit. I put my verse. Well, what it was like, it's like, okay, so who's going to go first on the verse? And then I had to put my verse. It's like, I wanted it for me.
So the news comes out. Cardi says someone close to her has leaked this information about having a baby. And then the album's called Invasion of Privacy. So when are we going to find out what's what, who's who, and what's happening?
Oh, well, you know, I just feel like people just got to tune in a little bit on my album. And maybe they just find out more about Invasion of Privacy. And they will know a little bit more. Because it's like, I can't address all the rumors and everything. I'll go crazy addressing all the rumors. And then on top of that, it's just like, I have been so open to people about myself. But it's just like, people cannot expect me to open about everything. Like, certain things to me, it has to be private. Like, people just always want to know, are you married to your dude or not? What do you feel about cheating? People just want to put their personal opinions about my life. And it's like, it's my life. And if I don't choose it to share with you, it's my personal. Like, you cannot invade my privacy. I'm not a damn animal at the zoo that you just could see everything. No.
Here's the thing about babies. When they arrive, people will know what's going on. And if they don't arrive, people will know what's going on.
And that's exactly the thing. If it arrives and if it don't arrive, then you're going to know what's going on.
Talk about the Grammys, man. I mean, you got nominated. Bodak Yellow was nominated. You performed with Bruno Mars, which I was in the building, so I know what that, and everybody was standing up. You know, I watched Hov, Beyonce, Diddy, Nas. Did you see them when you went out on stage? Could you see into the crowd and see them standing up for you?
I wasn't trying to look at the crowd because I was so nervous. I'm like, I'm gonna focus. I'm so scared. If I see them, I might pass out. And then I didn't want to forget no moves. So I just was like, I'm just going to look at a blank space. This is my blank space. Because I was just so nervous that day. I was freaking out, especially because I know that Bruno Mars, he's a perfectionist. And we did rehearsals every single day for like a whole week. So it's just like, I did not want to mess up because I do not want to disappoint this man.
How did the collab happen? The Finesse remix collab? Because that was another big deal, another big moment. It was a huge moment collaborating with Bruno Mars.
Somebody hit me up and they said that he wants to collab with me. And it's like, he wanna collaborate with me? He wanna collaborate with me. And we actually got in the studio and we did it together.
Oh, you did it together?
Yes, because he...
Did he help you get the old school, you know, because he had that old school zone on this album, like that New Jack Swing zone, y'all was wearing the cross colors. Was that his whole brainchild. Because even your flow on that record, drop top Porsche, rolling on my red, you know what I mean? That's a very like 90s flow.
Yeah.
Was that your zone? Did he help you with that zone?
I mean, it's something that is like on the beat, and then like he also like put his input on it, like in a really nice way, and all everything was like his idea, his vision, like this how he wanted it to dress, this how he wanted it to sound, this how he wanted it to look, and it's like I'm with the shit. I do whatever you want me to do.
That's it, cause this popping. Talk about sneak dissing. I hear you say that a lot. It's been a few records on the album. And there's always this energy that you've had. Obviously, there's been doubters, right? People who just doubted you. There's people who have, I don't know the whole story, but somehow you and Nicki Minaj got pitted against each other. And then you often talk about sneak dissing. So unpack that for me. Is there something between you and Nicki, or is that just internet made up?
I just feel like it's really internet made up. Like, I really feel like fans and people, they really want to see that happen because it's really entertaining. To see people beef is entertaining. Like, I am going from when Nicki and Remy was beefing, everybody was tuning in like, ooh, what's next? What's next? What's next? But I don't really have the time for that. Like, it's like, if you ain't my man, or if you're not taking my money from me, you're not stopping my money, then I don't really give a about you. People just want to pin it so much because it's entertainment, but they don't want to handle their own beef. And I spoke to her before in person, just like we're talking right now, like this close to each other. So it's just like I always say, like, I don't ever want nobody sneak this at me. I'm not the type of person that if it's something that you could talk it out, you could talk it out. Because it's not always rah, 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 this, rah, 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 that. Because we grown, unless you want to take it to the rah, rah, this, rah, rah, that. But other than that, it's just like, I just feel like fans just keep doing it. Like, they just keep doing it. They just keep doing it. Like, because they want it.
I thought it was a missed opportunity in a motorsport video to show some real camaraderie. But whatever schedules, I mean, weren't you guys together in the video at the same time?
I heard that she couldn't shoot that day.
And just timing.
I just heard that she couldn't shoot that day. And it's just like, people just made a lot of theories of everything. And it's just like, what is it that people expect from me to do or say? I already say she's an amazing artist. I already say I pay my respect to her. I did videos before jamming to her songs. Like, it's like, what do people expect? Like, y'all want me to say something bad. Y'all want to annoy me to the fact that I say something bad. And it's just like, I'm not falling for that.
You also on the album talk about people acting. Back in the day, they used to diss you. Like in high school days or when you stripping or whatever. And now people act like they was always cool with you. Like they was your friends.
But it's true. Like, it's like, let me tell you something. I will never forget, and this was December 22nd. It was a really bad night in the strip club. Like, it's like, it was really packed, and I felt like a lot of was making money, and I didn't make money. I told one of my exes that day, I told him, can you please lend me $10,000 so I could open a cleaning company? And he was just like, we just talk in the morning. And then he just kept, like, ignoring me about it. And then, now you tell me that you always knew that I was going to make it. How you always knew that I was going to make it? But you invest money on your homeboy that raps, but you never even couldn't even invest this little tiny $10,000 to open a cleaning company while you were staying in my house and f***ing me. So it's just like, it's just certain things that is like, that is so funny to me. And it's a lot of things that I dealt with like that. A lot of things, a lot of people, especially local DJs in New York.
Mm-hmm.
It's just like,
That didn't support me
or just didn't understand me. And it's just like, sometimes you just gotta prove things to people, and sometimes you cannot even, like, hold that grudge because not everybody's just gonna see it. And sometimes I have to tell myself, I gotta understand, like, you need to understand, Cardi, that you was a stripper. You have a heavy accent. You are a very funny person. Sometimes people are not gonna take serious on things that you talk about. You just gotta prove it to them. And when you prove it to them, you just cannot have that grudge. Like, if you ask an artist to be in your music, on your song, and they say no, don't take it personal. Like, what, you're not gonna work with them again? No, you just gotta continuously prove yourself. And then they might be the nicest, greatest person. Sometimes people just don't believe. You gotta make them a believer. Gotta make somebody a believer sometimes. And that's just what it is.
And look, man, salute, man. This album's phenomenal.
Yeah.
You feel, like, how do you feel getting this done, though? Like, talk about completion. Like, it's out now.
I feel like, whoo, it's a big weight on my shoulder. I feel confident. And I'm also very nervous. Like, I'm very nervous. It's my first time doing it. And the pressure that everybody was putting me under is just like, ooh, it's finally out.